Look in the Bible, in the second chapter of Genesis and the seventh verse. It says, "And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the earth, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul." Think of this, brothers and sisters. This is what the Honorable Elijah Muhammad has pointed out for us there in the Bible. It says, "And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the earth. And after he had formed this man, he breathed into the nostrils of this man the breath of life, and that man became a living soul." It doesn't say that God gave man a soul. It says that he breathed into the nostrils of this man the breath of life, and then that man himself became a living soul. But before that man became a living soul, he was a dead soul. You know yourself, beloved brothers and sisters, they compare the earth and the woman as one. Because the earth and the mother, the earth has soil, the mother has flesh. The earth has grass, the mother has hair. The earth has valleys and mountains, the mother has the various female bodily contours. The earth has water, the mother has blood. The earth has rivers and streams, the mother has arteries and veins. And just as it says here that man was formed from the earth, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us that man is formed from Mother Earth, but through man's mother. The woman carries, after the seed is deposited within the mother, she carries it, she nourishes it, she adds to it, she forms it. It takes shape, it takes its formation right within the mother. And after it is formed, at the end of 9 months, it comes forth, completely formed. It has everything right down to the fingernails and the toenails and the hair. It has everything except breath. And after that child comes into the world, the first thing that must be done, the doctor will spank it or sprinkle cold water on it to make it cry out and take in that first breath of air. After it takes in that first breath of air, it becomes a living soul. But if that child that is born never takes in that first breath of air, it is called stillborn. Or it means it's a dead soul. At no time does it say in the Bible that God gave man a soul, but it says that man himself is soul. As long as he lives, he's a living soul. And when he dies, he's a dead soul. If I look out the window of Muhammad's mosque right now, and I don't see anyone, I say, "I don't see anybody." Or I say, "I don't see a soul." When I don't see a soul, I don't see anybody. And when I don't see anybody, I say, "I don't see a soul." And it is true what the Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us, that man and soul are one. If you're alive, you're a living soul. If you're poor, you're a poor soul. If you're dumb, you're a dumb soul. And the Honorable Elijah Muhammad has been raised up from amidst of the so-called Negroes here in America to teach this truth. So let us know that we can forget about that life after death. We can forget about that heaven in the sky. We can forget about that hell down in the ground. He says that heaven and hell are right here on this earth. That God and the devil are right here on this earth.